Anyway, well, just look at the bracket. Exclamation point, bracket, thing usually does it. So we're gonna start.
Alright. Let's go ahead and get right into this. You guys already know what we're about to get. Garchomp action. We had a lot of Garchomp here this year.
Oh gosh, we had so many, an odd amount of Garchomps and Gengars in this one, in the second floor, I think was what it was.
That's okay. Alright, who's playing here one more time? This is, what's his name? Oh, there it is. Eclipse. Oh, Nick. Oh, the thing's kind of blocking.
We just call him Roxo.
Roxo versus Eclipse.
Oh! Charge Bank out.
Alright. Puts him against the wall. And I really like what I'm seeing here, man. Just, you gotta really set the tone early sometimes in these matches, especially if you're gonna play a character like Reebok.
Eclipse had really good pressure to go. Oh, that's fun. Oh, no, it's not in burst. I forgot.
Right.
Nice pressure from Eclipse.
He's definitely plays ground right here. You know he has the footwork now. Love that assist.
Alright, he's the Togekiss master.
It almost is like quick he can move on that.
I like him so much that we have a very tiny grab. Now, I am a little confused. I thought Dig dodged Monster Pound, but it doesn't dodge Monster Crush. Something I need to look at.
Right. When it's in a very angry letter to the Pokemon. Like, hey, did you guys see this?
I remember somebody said that in real life. Something about how I can crush the strange interaction in this matchup. I was not listening, and now I wish I was. I didn't do it. Into round two. Lifts up one round.
Okay, tries to set the trap. Good patience.
What is... Okay, Eclipse did this to me in front of him. I guess he's just, let's see. Oh, he's trying to push me somewhere. This point's desirable. We're right in the middle of the field.
I like the fact he uses a snow to kind of alleviate the pressure.
Oh, nice move.
Got it. It's just a lot of back and forth here for this part, but I really like what I'm seeing from Eclipse. Like I said before, you know, if you don't set the tone early when the match starts, then you really want to be a little bit more hurt. Oh my god.
Lovely spacing from Roxo. Eclipse didn't want to take a ton of risk, and Roxo capitalized on that. Eclipse is hanging on, but the last threat is health.
That hurts to see, man, when it really comes down to that.
Yeah, Roxo playing it very nicely, though. Nice jump back away from pretty much anything that looks pretty. Weavile's reach is not pretty. You can stay a little bit farther, but it's very hard to touch you. Until he catches up and commits to something, probably.
I had an email. Went right for the grab right there. He's in his A.
Okay. Not that I think that Weavile now has to fly. He's locked in the way. That's decent frame data. Other than that.
Fancy footwork there. Both players kind of dancing around each other.
Goes back in.
Oh, he actually made that.
He almost made it out.
Yeah. That was some sick stuff.
He really wants to taunt you. Which is, I see why. Because Garchomp can pop first. You don't want to really deal with Garchomp first.
No, not at all. Okay, he shook. You know the lessons. I'm not moving an inch.
Okay.
Respect
going on.
Alright, too much respect.
Eclipse staying far away, making Roxo wasted first. Leon, whatever Eclipse fades him. It's another interesting card right now that Leon didn't get to stop it. Oh, this is a good character. Eclipse makes it even better. He's not want to deal with Garchomp. He doesn't have to. I think he has like just barely the life lead. He can run away. Yep.
I'm smart. Very smart. He's not very happy about that. I don't know if they can see the player camera from the depth.
This teeny tiny little camera at the bottom. Yeah. Rox was up in front. Eclipse is a little bit farther back. Man, Rox could just bury this poor Pikachu. Is what I'm saying.
Rest in Pikachu.
Eclipse up one game.
Alright. As we've seen in the past, it's not about how you start, it's most certainly about how you finish here. So let's see if we get a little bit of adjustment here. Game number two.
So much much Eclipse is just doing right, and Rockstar just has to change his game plan here. That counter lasted like a decade. Good use of stuff.
See a bit more defense here for Roxas. Oh my god, why did I say that? Comes in a little too haphazard. Finds himself getting grabbed, but that was really interesting, man. You know, just decided to kind of sit and guard for a while. We didn't see a lot of that in that first game.
It's really hard, I think, trying to catch up once Togekiss gets the Togekiss, because now Garchomp's modest speed becomes even more. I guess his running speed and field tech are pretty good. I did underestimate that for a second.
Oh, yeah. Okay, immediate shit.
Oh, no.
So don't even get too close, man.
Pop burst. Does not matter. Zuba will get burst again.
Oh, yeah, easy.
If you pop, I don't know if Togekiss gives synergy, but Zuba almost never has to worry about burst. Nice fake out.
Oh, a little out of range there that time, but I do like the attempt. There's nothing wrong with that. Oh my god, find himself back into the corner that time, too. Gets his way in.
Uh-oh. Oh no.
Here we go.
Here comes the Garchomp damage. Oh, what's me? I'm supposed to fake out. Eclipse is ready with those taunts. Taunt is one of the best buttons. Oh my gosh.
Space to work with. Tries to push it back here. He's gonna be moving and grooving here.
That was pretty dangerous. If you jump versus the burst Weavile and you can't get down, you're eating a giant burst in the face.
Oh, he actually charged it up that time too. That was smart.
Making sure that Garchomp cannot get burst himself. Mm-hmm.
Okay, like I said, man, it's a little bit more defense here in this game. Like in that game number one, you probably would have ate a couple of those.
Ah, he's I feel like he should have probably held on the block at that point, because he has the life lead. You have the life lead. Be careful. You have the life lead.
You gotta hold on to it.
I think, no, the wall damage might have brought him down a little too far. No, he's still okay. Just barely okay. There's a lot of risks, but he is still in this. But still on max point.
That's right. Cliff is really good here. He can most certainly be looking better, but I guess we're just gonna have to take what we can get at this point. Okay. Throws out the sand.
That exchange.
Oh, the way he's just able to capitalize off of this little small thing, man, it's just really going to just. The minute he gets you against the wall, you already know what's about to go down.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, he knows he absolutely needs to approach here. This is certainly the spot he wants to be here in the match.
I like how he's trying to parry some of these types of things. He's good at utilizing Weavile's super kind of frame to. There we go.
He knew he was going to grab. How did he know? Roxo looking good here.
Now, Garchomp's high stance can tech certain moves. I don't know what the rules are. You cannot tech grabs.
Okay. Final game here, because only top 8 is. Are you guys doing best of 5 for top 8? Is that how that's working?
Best of 5 is. Top 3.
Just talk to winners, losers, and
I think we're deciding. Yeah.
Okay. Well, in the meantime.
If we're wrong, we'll find out, because we'll still be here.
Right. Right. But in the meantime, these matches here are probably going to be close to the street, if anything.
Especially because Weavile, if he has life, he's just going, okay, I don't want to be here. I can die anything in the book if I try hard enough.
See it. Not a blast.
Digs right to the counter. That's what I like.
Shift the play stop over here.
Nice!
The sword thing, but now he's starting to turn it up. Really quick. Oh my god. Wow.
This boy actually did the JX combo. That's like super one. Ooh!
Not looking good.
He's green, man.
Don't move.
Ooh, oh my god, he's like, oh, thank you for coming out. Give me free brick meter.
Please and thank you.
Garchomp does have Umbreon with his ability. Okay, now he's like, Garchomp is out of resources.
Oh, wait, did he press the button? Oh, he jumped out of the way.
Oh,
15
no.
seconds left, though. This could be the turnaround we need here.
Eclipse is in trouble. Okay, so, AY is unsafe. I believe Eclipse got a little ahead by
Are you serious?
No, Roxo.
Are you serious?
Roxo.
This is it.
Run. Run, my fish man. Okay.
Wow.
Roxo's definitely still in this.
It's crazy to see the shift in demeanor from both of these two players. I mean, obviously, they're both highly regarded in what it is they do, but one guy's very emotional. You can see it on his sleeve, while the other guy's probably like having a mental meltdown.
I think Roxo's been really good at adapting so far. Eclipse is just, I mean, besides adapting, he just naturally knows his character so well. It's really cool.
Yeah, it just shows like a little bit of adaptation goes a long way. When you beat game number one, I'm not even the best, but it's all about the readjustment to game number two, and hopefully, you can obviously game number three. Depending on where you are in bracket. Oh,
that's my goal, I think.
Running time right here, beautiful stuff, gets the grab.
First, and he can bring this back in the gift with butter.
Okay. Both players very patient here, you know, just not the explosiveness that we were used to seeing here a little bit earlier. I think they both certainly know what's on the line.
Getting the synergy nuggets.
Oh, he's not going to
do it. It's like, yeah, he's going to pop up around because he doesn't want to do whatever.
Oh, God.
That was the last of the speed buff. Eclipse still has to do enough damage to raw knockoff. Oh no, that's gonna make the hit. He doesn't have enough time to bring his back. It's a raw burst of
rage. That's gonna do it.
Roxo just has to run for 2 seconds.
Oh,
what? My lad just came across town and did a ding. This lad. Actually took the game with the dig in neutral.
Right, nobody knew what to do. We're gonna clap here because we're